Hare Krishna. Question from Anuj Agarwal Prabhu. What is the difference between jnani and jnana yogi? Is it explained somewhere in the Bhagavad Gita? Answer: jnani refers specifically to a person who possesses knowledge. Jnana yogi refers to a person who is following the process of jnana yoga, which is one of the yogas within the Vedic tradition. And now this specific difference is not mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, because the Bhagavad Gita is a philosophical book. It is not a lexicological book. It is not a dictionary which gives word meanings, and it doesn't technically differentiate between words like that. But we see that the Bhagavad Gita does talk about these concepts broadly. As we know, Jnana Yoga is a particular kind of sadhana which focuses primarily on intellectual contemplation, and it's a naiti, by naiti saying no to matter. One tries to understand the reality beyond matter. So in the 18th chapter, verses 49 onwards to 53 roughly, they talk about the process of jnana yoga, and there the focus is on detachment from the world, and after that the person comes to bhakti yoga. 54 is brahma bhuta prasannatama, and then after that such a person mad bhaktim labhate param, such a person attains my bhakti. So the acharya generally explained that this section refers to bhakti, jnana yoga. Now moving forward, the word jnani is used in the Bhagavad Gita. Tesham jnani nitya yukta ek bhaktir visheshyate. So tesham jnani, this is jnani. What kind of jnani is there? This is Krishna is referring here the four kinds of people who surrender to him. He has talked about them, he mentioned them in 4.16, and then among those four, Krishna is saying in this verse 4.17 that visheshyate is special. Sham jnani nitya yukta ek bhaktir. So the point is, Krishna is using the word jnani, but the subsequent qualification that is describing, nitya yukta, always engaged. And what engaged in what? Ek bhaktir, in devotion. Such a person is special. So Krishna is practically describing this person may have come from the jnana, from the path of intellectual contemplation, from an intellectual analysis, from wanting to understand the absolute truth in an intellectual way, but that person is for all practical purposes doing bhakti sadhana only. Eka bhaktir visheshyate. So he's one pointed in devotion. That means this person is, this jnani is not a jnana yogi that Krishna is talking about. Krishna refers here to the person who is who approaches Krishna with knowledge. That means, okay, there must be some reality beyond this world. I want to know what that reality is. I want to develop a relationship with that reality. So the person approaches. So because of that, this jnani is already free from material motives. And that's why to connect with Krishna becomes much easier and swifter. And it's also much more pleasing to Krishna, because the person is coming with a relatively selfless motive. Now the other three categories of people, Krishna said that they are artho, jignyasu, arthaarthi. They will become bahunam janmanamante jnanavan mam prapadyate. They will become jnanavan after some time. It may take several lifetimes also. They will become possessors of knowledge. So jnani can refer to, so a devotee can also be a jnani in the sense that, now we often use the word jnani in a very negative sense. Don't be a jnani. But Jiva Goswami in his Bhakti Sandarbhas, as well as in the Durgam Sangamani commentary on the NOD, Nectar of Devotees, Bhakti Samrita Sindhu, he describes how there is good jnana and there is a bad jnana. There is Shushka jnana, is the jnana which focuses on oneness of the soul with the super soul. But the good jnana is that which focuses on the glory of Krishna and focuses on how the soul is different from Krishna, in the sense that soul is tiny and soul, God is great, Krishna is great, and therefore it increases one's devotion to Krishna. So the word jnani is not the monopoly of jnana yogis. The word jnani is a generic term to refer to those who are having knowledge. And bhaktas actually have the highest knowledge. As the Chaitanya Charan says, Jai Krishna Vaji, Sei Bada Chature. Supreme is extremely wise. And Krishna also says, who are the Jnanavan? Maam Prapadyate, those who surrender to me, those who become my devotees. So in that sense, Jnan Yogi refers to a seeker of a particular, on a particular path. Jnani refers to the person who has knowledge that can be from any path, and to the Bhakta who has the fullest knowledge. Thank you.